Before we get started, I'll brief you all about group leaders and speaker for the event. Sagar Arora, Community Group Leader of Salesforce Admin Group Khandwa, Sonali Durjan, and myself, Manasvi Garak, Community Group Leaders of Salesforce Admin Group Nasik. So we have Chitranshi Saxena amongst us today, and she will be sharing her knowledge on a Salesforce product, Marketing Cloud, throughout the session. Chitranshi is a Salesforce certified professional with strong consulting and marketing technology implementation experience. A warm welcome to Chitranshi, and I now request Chitranshi to start with the session. Over to you, Chitranshi.
Thanks, Manasvi, for introducing me, and thanks to all of you for group leaders for inviting me to this session, and thanks to all for joining this session over the weekend. I hope this session will be informative to all of you guys. So let me just share my screen. Let me know once it is visible. Is it visible now?
Yes, Chitranshi, it's visible.
Okay, so let's just start with introduction to Marketing Cloud. This is the agenda of today's webinar, like Marketing Cloud overview. In this, we will throw out all the studios and channels which are available in the Marketing Clouds, configure Marketing Cloud. It will go through like how we can, when we get the org, first org, which is newly fresh, and how we can configure that Marketing Cloud so that we can send the emails or mobile SMS and all, creating users and assigning permissions. So it will cover creating the users and assigning permission and role to those users, data model or storage, data storage. It will cover how the data is stored in the Marketing Cloud and how this perform, for how this is used across all the channels, common Marketing Cloud studios and channel. This will go through about all these studios and channel a little bit. Marketing Cloud automation and journeys. This will cover all the automations available inside the automation studio and journey builder. Journeys, how we can create that. Integration with various cloud. This will cover how we can integrate with the other cloud like sales and service. And last, career option, how you can go ahead with the Marketing Cloud knowledge. And last, so as the Marketing Cloud is itself in a very high demand and a very big platform, so it is not possible for me to cover everything. So I will just try to give you guys a overview for that. So first of all, let's come to the what's the difference between sales and marketing. So I just wanted to be a session interactive. So guys, what just ping in the chat what you understand with the sales and marketing, and what's the difference between those. I just wanted to know about your opinion. Any suggestions, any think you guys understand about what's the difference between sales and marketing? Okay, marketing is lead nurturing, sales is B2C, and marketing is B2B. Okay, sales is selling and marketing is way we can use screen. Okay, I think you are a little bit aware about what is the difference between sales and marketing. It is good to know. Now next one is, which one is more important? So what do you think, guys, which one is more important between sales and marketing? Sales, both, marketing. Okay, yes, both are equally important. Okay, so it's good to see that you are aware about this. Okay, so let me just share my opinion. Like, marketing is just understanding the customer needs, what the we can just before launching any product, so we will identify what the customer needed. And sales is work with qualified leads. like when we capture all the information, like this information is needed to customer, then we work with the qualified lead. In marketing, general insights and identify audience, it will target to the audience which is right one. It can segment those audience like in the basis of behavior or geographical and gender base. All these things can be identified in the marketing cloud. And brand awareness, through marketing we can produce the awareness inside the people for the particular brand. Content generation and marketing itself, we generate the content to be to advertise. And marketing strategy, including channels, personal, it includes the strategy through which we can do the marketing for our product. And sales work with the focus on selling and closing on opportunities. Building trust with end customer, it builds the trust between the customers. Sales strategy, including channels. Marketing strategy, including channels, execution and pipeline management. So this is the thing we can do the, like what this one is the sales and this one is the marketing. So let's come to the another, like what is the B2B and B2C marketing. So B2B is like about just focus on the organization, and it can involve the decision makers. It can have the longer time period in comparison to B2C, as this contains all the decision making and strategic planning. In B2B, the deal size is large and the less number of leads are there. Help us improve customer acquisition, like how we can improve the customer acquisition, how we can engage more customers for our product. And B2C is about just it is redirect to the end customer. It usually takes the single decision maker, like which is itself the customer, and it contains the smaller deal size and it contains the shorter time engagement in comparison to B2B, and it contains the large number of leads and help from customers to acquire something they desire or they need. It can directly contact with the customer. So in B2C we can directly approach what the customer needs, so it will be helpful for what customer need and what is their desire. So based on that we can generate our product or make it more productive. So for most of you have heard about the Pardot. So for marketing, for B2B, we use usually the Pardot, and for B2C, we use Marketing Cloud. Now let's come to the Marketing Cloud overview. So as some of you are a little bit aware about Marketing Cloud, is the aware about the studios and channel. So when you listen the word studio, that is directly redirect to based on the particular channels, like email studio based on the particular like is designed for sending or receiving the email. Mobile studio is designed for the marketing for mobile, and social studio is for social media, and advertising studios like just advertise through their Google or any other applications, and web studios directly like linking in the web particular link and all. So these are the studios inside the Marketing Cloud, and the builder basically contains, produce the or manage the contents which we can use across all the studios and channels. So in Marketing Cloud we have Audience Builder, which we use to segment the customers and engage the customer, and we can plan how we can relate or manage the relationship between the customers and the products. Personalization is about like segmenting the data of the customer and how we can personalize the thing based on the customer's activity and all these engagement things. Content Builder is like about in Content Builder we can generate the content which can be used across the channels. And Analytics Builder is about like reporting and all these things, like how many emails is sent or how many customers has opened the email. So all these things we can manage across the Analytics Builder. So let me just give you a brief overview through the org. So here's the Marketing Cloud org. When you log in from the exact target platform, you will redirect to this org. So here are some channels like studios, email studio, mobile studio, social studio, advertising, web studio, and interaction studio. And here are some builders, as told in the PPT, analytics builder, journey builder, content builder, audience builder, and all those things. So here are some business unit. A business unit is basically about the separate workspace which we can use across the marketing cloud. Suppose like we have the particular university, and the university have a particular colleges. So the university will be a parent business unit, and the colleges, those colleges have their entire separate work and their entire functioning. So those should be keep separate between different amongst colleges. So we can define those colleges inside this parent business unit. But the thing is, all the content is shared with the parent business unit. So this is the concept behind the parent business unit. And this one comes under the setup. So when you got the new org, like just suppose a customer has purchased org and you have just given. So first, the first thing you have to do, you have to just register your address from security or company setting, and after that you need to create users, and for that, like here, from here you can create the users. Once you have created the users, you can assign the permission. Like permission are basically restrict to the particular user for accessing a particular application. So like this one user is created, you can create the user from here. So you will mention all these information here, like name, reply, email address, and you need to verify that email address while using the this org. And notification, you can use all these things and just click on save. After you have created the user, you can assign or manage role. Like if you want to assign any particular role to this, then you can directly go to the manage roles. So now no role is assigned to this user. So these are the standard roles in the marketing cloud administrator, which can be an admin for the org, and analyst, which can just analyze the data based on that. Content creator, that the person having the content creator role will be able to create the content inside the content builder. Data manager can use the contact builder. So these are some predefined roles inside the marketing cloud. You can just assign the roles from here and just click on save. So the role will be assigned to the particular user, and user can work to the system. So these are all the things, like configure marketing cloud. So from here, it is the dashboard, which you can see, like setup home. Over here you can see that how many emails has been sent from this, and how many journeys are overall running through this marketing cloud org, and how many stops. So a little bit overview will be come to this window. You can, as an admin, you can visualize all the things like automations and where are the errors. So you can just have a look and take a visualization for this window. So guys, just post your queries inside the chat. At the end of the session, we will cover all these queries. So creating user, which I have already told. Assigning roles, you can assign the roles from here. And next one is data models. So everything in the marketing cloud just revolves around the contact, like customers. So contact data is like can be a demographic profile or channel identifier, and it can be a relational behavior transactional, like there are these two different types of data is there. Like one is subscriber and another one is contact. So the subscriber, at the time when you sent an email to a particular customer to a particular email, then when the email is sent, then a particular customer has become the subscriber. So this is the thing, and when an email is sent, then subscriber is set to the active state. And another one is term is context. So any data inside the marketing cloud refers to the context, like whether you are sending from mobile and whether you are sending from advertisement, and anything you do like come under to this context. So has a difference between the context and the subscriber. The subscribers just used for the you can say that in terms of email, and context you can say in terms of email or mobile or any other social platform which refers to the context. And another one is how we can store the data in the marketing cloud. So there are two options available. So first one is data extension, and another one is subscriber list. So data extension covers store the data across all the channels, and subscriber list is all about for storing data for the particular email, or you can say that the subscriber list store the data of subscriber. So let me just give you a overview like how we can create the data extension. And from here, inside the email studio, you can create the list and the data extension. So inside subscriber tabs, you can see that all the subscribers available which for which the email is sent from the org. So let me just give you a brief overview about email studio. Once you can access the email studio from here, email. And after that, this window will come. So again, this window will just summarize all the things like how many sends are sent from the particular system and how many are pending and what is the delivery date for that. Also, you can say that you can see that if you are sending the email for a particular data extension, then you can see which percent of email has been sent, like this one, 66.7% of email has been sent to the customer. And you can say that all the things like what is the subject and what is the name and how many subscriber has been sent for this. So all the things are you can access from here. And this is the like quick links for creating the emails, templates, and which are available. So this is just a overview tab. You can directly create the data extension from here or create the list from here. So these are some shortcuts. And content here, you can just get all the subscribers available in the marketing cloud which are active and like the subscriber inside the all the subscriber list. You can access all the subscriber from here as well, this one. So you can just check whether the subscriber is inactive or not. If the subscriber is unsubscribed, then this information will be shown here. And through this, you can see that why, if anyone has blocked, then you can see that the history over here, how many emails has been blocked or not. All the histories for 90 days, you can see over here if a particular email is blocked. And if a customer is saying that he doesn't receive the email, then you can manage all the things from here, like this one. If the customer is claiming that ABC type of customer has not received an email, then you can just check for the email, and you can just drop your email in all subscriber list and check whether it is bounced or not. So as you can see that there are two bounces. So once a customer has bounced, then it will go to the blacklist. You can say that inactive. So you can find all the history over here. And there are some other things like list. You can create the list from here, this one. Or groups. Profile management is basically like storing the customer information, like some informations are necessary, customer's names or email for which the email is sent. So all the things which are the standard information for the customer, you can define the profile management here when you are going to use inside your email. So these are some fields which will be necessary for defining when you are defining a particular subscriber. So you can define whether it is required or not. So obviously for sending an email, email address is required. So this profile attribute is defined here as required, yes. So this will contain inside the profile management. Other one is preference management is like it stores the preference of the customer, like how the customer wants to receive an email in the text format or HTML email. So it is just like a checkbox or a type of field. So you can define a particular customer wants to receive a email in the form of HTML email. So all these things are stored inside the preference management. Another one is data extension. So data extension is the most important part for the marketing cloud. There are some limitations for the list because as lists are used for the limitation in the sense of storing the data or speed and all these things, lists have some limitations. You cannot query for that. You cannot do the API callout for that. So there are some limitations for this, for the list. So to overcome the list limitations of the list, we use the data extension. So data extension, we can send n number of data and n number of fields we can define inside the list. So here are the three types of data extension. First one is standard data extension, another one is filtered data extension, and third one is random data extension. So standard data extension is just about storing the data of the customer in the form of table format. And filtered data extension is about when you have created a particular data extension and you want to take some particular fields inside the data extension. So you can use the filtered data extension. And random data extension is about you just taking some random data based on that. Like for a particular test data extension, you want to have only 60% of data. So you can use random data extension in that way. So let's just go proceed with the standard data extension. Click on OK. So you can say that you can define here whether you want to create from the create new or existing or from template. So here we are selecting the create new. You just provide your data extension name. It should be unique across all of your data extension. So I'm just providing the name test demo DE. Here you can define the external data key if you want to provide. It is not mandatory, but external key can be used while using when you are querying for a particular data. So external key can be used in that sense, but it is not mandatory. It is up to you whether you are providing or not. Here you can provide your data extension description. Then you can see when you want to test for a particular data extension, then you can or want to send an email from a particular data extension, then you need to choose and testable. If you don't use the it is as sendable and don't mark it as check, then you can send the email from here. You can send the email from this detection. So it is needed to select as is sendable. So just click on next, and here's the data retention policy, which is basically used for like after a particular period of time, you want that the record will be disappear from the data extension. So for that purpose, we use the data retention policy. So you can define when you turn it as on, then you can define after how much time of after how much time you want to remove all the records from the data extension. So it is good to when you know that your particular data extension contains the data on the daily basis and it is no longer needed after a certain period of time. So you can just use the retention policy and the data will be erased from here. So for now, I'm just closing it. I'm not mentioning. Just click on next. Here we will define our fields for which we need to store our data. So like first one, I'm taking the first name. Another one is last name, and third one is email. you can define the data type here, and for this one I'm taking the email address as a field. So the point to be noted there is that if you are not using data type email address here, then when you are sending email from this data extension, so the email will not be sent, because at the time of send it will check for the email address type of data type of field. So if it will not found it over here, then the email will bounce and it will not be sent. So it should be a email address type of field. You can take it phone and anything you want. So this should be a phone type of field, and you need to define any primary key over here. So for sending email, primary key should be email address, or you can define based on your requirement. And you can define whether the field should be nullable or not, and all these things, and the default value over here. And you can define the send relationship is basically when at the time of send, when the it is look for the subscriber, and it will check for the subscriber key. So for it will check for the relationship, like particular subscriber is associated with what field. So it will check like email. So it will just add into these all subscriber list after checking this relationship with the email. So let's just create it. So you can search your data extension from here. So over here you can see that now it has only zero records, because we have not inserted any data over here. So you can if your data extension has some data and you want to export that, then you can do import the data inside this. You can directly do it from here. It provides two options. When the data is too large, like more than 20 MB, then you can import the data from the FTP server. For that, you need to configure the FTP through the setup. And if your data is less than 20 MB, then you can just import your data from the file available on your system. So if I'm using the and the point to be noted here is that the file should be in CSV format. So if you want to import, you can just select my computer and just browse your file and just import the data from here. So here are the two options. First one is for my computer, and the one is FTP. And the one is if you want to filter your data based on some condition, then you can create your filter like email should contain this, and first name should start with this name. So you can apply a filter on your data extension as well. So you can view all the properties. Like if you want to change your properties like subscribe a key and all the things, you can do from here and add it. If you want to import your report, you can directly do from it, or directly can do from the contact builder as well. Or if you want to clear your data or empty your data extension, then you can clear the data from here. So this contains inside the data extension. And another one is synchronized data extension. Synchronized data extension is basically contains all the data which comes from Salesforce, any other org like Sales Cloud or Service Cloud. So all the data comes inside the synchronized data extension. Like you have mapped your object like lead or contact. So all the data comes inside the synchronized data extension. Another one is shared data extension, like data extension which you have shared across among the business units can come under this data extension. Audiences shared. So all these things, like another one is important, like sub-publication list. You are sending a newsletter, so you can use these publication lists and can import the context inside this. And suppression list is like when you don't want to send emails to a particular list of subscriber, then you can just import this data extension, and you know that your that list of subscriber contains inside the data extension which you are using at the time of sending. So what you can do from here, you can just create a suppression list from here and just take all the subscriber for which you don't want to send the emails and just import in this list, and at the time of sending the email you can choose the suppression list as a suppression. So for that, the email will not be sent to the subscribers which are contained inside this suppression list. So it is also one of the most important type of list which is used generally. And here are the data filters which you can create a filter and use inside the filter data extension. And here are some measures. So these come inside the subscriber tag. And another tab is like interaction. Here you can just import the data from here. And another one is user initiated send. Like when you are sending the email, like your motive is to just create a particular send and just sending to a list of subscriber. So you can just create from here. You just wanted to run a campaign from here, like you have some data extension and you have some templates to be created. So you can define your here and you can just use your emails, whether you can use your classic emails or content builder emails. So for content builder emails, you can choose which email you want to send. Like this one email you want to send. So the subject will be automatically populated to the subject field, and preheader you can insert, and you can choose your send classification, like are you sending for commercial one or transactional one, and you can choose your sender profile. Sender profile is like contains your all information, like deliver your sender information, your from address, your company information, all these comes under this sender profile. And the delivery profile contains the data like unsubscribe options and preference attribute. All the things comes under the delivery profile. So you can choose your sender profile, like from which email you want to send, like this one. So the email will be populated like this person has sent the email. So all the information will be appended when you send the email to a particular subscriber. So send logging is basically it will enable the log for a data extension that you can review when the email is sent. And added recipients, here you can just specify a name. So added recipient, you can select here for a particular data extension to which you want to send your email, like this one. A problem occurred, please create customer definition test extension. I think there's some issue with the template, that's why it is showing here already. Yes, so it will not pick for the duplicate name, that's why it is showing this error. So over here you can see that a test send is already there, so it is not taking that. So by defining another name and from choosing the data extension and suppression list, you can just define your recipients and suppression list which you want to suppress from send. So all these things cover inside the Interaction Studio. Like you can send the Salesforce send emails or triggered emails. A/B testing is like all about when you want to test which version of your email will perform better to the customers before sending, in the form of subject, in the form of content, and all these things you can view from the A/B testing. And tracking contains all the data like which for a particular email, how much if email has been bounced, and all these things you can find from here, like this for this one. You can see that total sent are there. There were only two emails to be sent. This will tracking and contains all the information which we have used inside the which we have sent for the user initiated emails or journey builder or anything you can find from the tracking. So here you can see that the total sent was 2, and you can find the emails for that as well from here, like this one. So admin part just contains setting up the emails, and also this will cover inside the email studio part. So let's come to the another one. So here are some common marketing cloud studios and channel. Email studio I have already described, like channel for marketing email. If you want to if you want to use the email as a marketing channel, then you will use the email studio. Here the subscriber model and subscriber model is used. As I have already told that the email which is sent to a particular customer, that customer has become the subscriber in the active state. Profile and preference attributes, like profile attribute is about the information of the particular subscriber, and preference attribute is like how the customer want to receive that email. So list and data extension, which I have already covered. In email studio you can do all these things like send emails, track sends, scan spam compliance list. ISP has defined some regulations for the customer, like for sending the email the customer should be opting. You can't send the email to anyone of from your designers, but the customer should be opting in for receiving the email. So some compliances are there which are defined inside the CAM spam compliance. And another one is commercial versus transactional email. Like commercial email is like for you are promoting for a particular business, like for Myntra and Season, and all these things are comes under the commercial sense. And transactional emails is about for you if you are receiving the bank emails and OTP generation. These all emails are comes under the transactional email. And unsubscribe as per the CAM spam compliance, and unsubscribe option should be there inside the email studio. So this will also come inside the profile sender profile automatically. Another one is mobile studio. So if you are looking forward to plan your marketing with mobile, so you can use your mobile studio. So mobile studio covers all the mobile connect channel, like SMS channel. You can send the SMS to a particular customer, send outbound SMS message, like if you want to send for a particular app, then you can use the mobile push notification group. Like mobile marketing cloud also providing some functionality for sending the emails across app, messenger app like Line, WhatsApp, Messenger. So you can send the mobile messages over there as well, and in-app messages, like if you want to provide any message inside the app, like pop-up message. So you can use across these functionality inside mobile studio as well. So these two studios are paid, mobile studio and social studio, and you have to take the license for take additionally by purchasing the marketing cloud. So another one is social studio. As the name suggests, the social studio, if you want to plan your marketing with the help of social sites, so you can use the social studio. It will cover across all the social media channels like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube. So you can just do your marketing from social studio. Here you can just you have some workspace. You can listen the marketplace, like what customer is saying about your product. So based on some hashtags and based on some keywords, you can identify what customer is saying for your product. So you can just analyze all the things and map the customer journey accordingly. So another one, we have web studio. Like in today's scenario, we are getting some emails like which redirect to a particular form. So you can design those form inside the web studio. You can design the form from here, and you can just append the link generated from the form to your email. So once the customer receives the email and click on that link will redirect to a particular form, and like a survey form you can design over here. So based on that, you can also capture the data directly from the customer. So here you can use your classic editor or content builder editor, or you can use your programming skills, which are the standard, like programming languages, AmpScript, SSJS. So these can be used inside the Web Studio. Another one is Automation Studio. Automation Studio is all about like you want to automate the things, like if someone has dropped the file inside your FTP server, or you want to send an email, so you can do such kind of things from there. If you want to take a file and sending the data to a particular data extension, or if you want to export your data from Marketing Cloud to outside, so all these things can be covered inside the Automation Studio. So it contains the schedule and triggers, and like you are defining for a particular schedule that this automation will run at a particular schedule, so you can define it here. And triggered file of like triggers, and it's like when the particular file is uploaded on the OTP, then the automation should be run. So these things can be defined inside the Automation Studio. File transfer, here are some standard activities inside the automation, like file transfer, import activity, SQL activity. You can do the query from this, send email, filter, filter. So these are the standard activities inside the Automation Studio. With these kinds of activities, you can design your automation. Another one is Journey Builder. Journey Builder is basically one-to-one customer engagement tool. You can directly engage with the customer throughout this. You can map the, you can personalize, engage, and the customer throughout throughout his entire journey through the Journey Builder. It is again two type. Single step. So in single step, you are just configuring, like you have just take a schedule or sending and just take a data extension and you are just sending. So it will contain inside the single step. Multi step, you can define based on the attributes and based on the conditional. So you can define the multi step from here. You can again here you can send the transactional, send entry sources, different type of entry sources here. I will show you later. So different types of entry sources there, like you are taking from the API event or data extension, or you are taking the data from the Salesforce data extension. So there are some different kinds of entry sources are there inside the Journey Builder. So here also some schedule automation is there, activities are there. You can use your standard activity or can plan your custom activities inside and then can use inside the Journey Builder, and you can update the data to the other clouds like sales or service through this Journey Builder. It is a cross-channel engagement platform. Here are some simple case, like use case, like you are sending, you are just sending the email to a particular, your motive is to send an email to a particular customer and just track this. This will come inside the simple use case, like welcome journey, like customer has registered to your website and the data store is stored inside your data extension and you are just sending to the data for welcome. So you can say that you can do that with the help of welcome journey. And card appointment journey, like if the particular customer has just added a particular product inside a cart and he has just turned off the mobile or just logged off from the app, so by engaging that, you can just remind the customer that you have added the particular product inside your cart, and you can define the additional promo codes or offers so that the customer will be tempted to the product and purchase the product which they have added in the cart. So this will come inside the card amendment journey, and much more are there inside the Journey Builder. And another one is Content Builder. So through Content Builder, it is a share tool to manage content across the channels, and you can define your content inside the Content Builder and can be used across the channels like mobile studio or email studio. So you can use the content, you can just define your content and use inside the across channels, and you can share the content across the business unit, like you have defined the particular content in the shared folder. So with the help of that, you can share the content to the across business units. Another one is Audience Builder. Audience Builder is basically contains all your data and you define the relationship between your customer, like you are defining the relationship between the product and customer, like a particular customer is associated with particular product or particular brand. So all these things can be configured inside the audience builder. Here the attribute groups are defined, like DE linking content, like you have some two data extension, like customer and the product. So you can link both of the data extension with the help of audience builder. You can delete the context inside the data audience builder. So let's just give you overview about these channels. This one, so mobile studio, over here you can define the messages. I don't have the license right now, so I can just give you an overview. It is little bit slow rather comparison to another platform. So again, you can view the overview, like how many emails has been sent and all these things from this overview tab. Sends, you can define your sends and view your activity. You can view all your activity, like filter to a particular date or particular month from here. Administrator, you can define your new app and configure the app based on that. So all these things can be defined inside this. I don't have the license right now, so I can't show you how we can configure those. So another one is Social Studio. Again, this requires additional license for engaging the customer on the social media. So this will ask for login, this one. So you need to take a username and password and then you can use that platform. This one is Advertising Studio. This also requires the license. And another one is Cloudbase. This I can show you. Like you can define you can define the pages inside this. This will redirect to this one, and you can just sort it by this and create your collection. And inside that, you can define your linked page. Like I have created this one, so it is just required. You can use it as the content builder. So over here, you can see that you can just add the button from here and define the things like button text and all the things. So it is just drag and drop and configuration basis. If you want to code, then you can just go to the HTML editor block and all these things, like defining the border, button, background button, and which after clicking on this button, which link it should be redirected to. So all these things can be defined from here, and you can remove this. So with the help of these content blocks like button, free from, HTML, all the things can be used inside this cloud page form. So like when you click on save and click on schedule publish, then a link will be generated. So through this, you can see that it is like a survey type of form. So you can define and fill your name here. This one, and provide your mobile number and just choosing your product, and on submitting it, the data will be stored on the designated data extension. So in this way, you can just capture your customer's data into your marketing cloud. So this will come inside the web studio. Interaction Studio is again, I don't have the license for that. Analytics Studio Builder is like, if you want to do any mobile, if your application is running, and you want to engage your customers, so you can choose at the which locations the customer is more active. So you can define all the things from here, like from particular date to date, which at which location your customer is active. So you can define this from here, like viewing browser, from which browser your application has been seen most times. So product purchase, you can define, you can view all of your product from here, like for a particular date, how many product of product has been purchased. So all these things you can visualize from here, web and mobile analytics. And here's one more thing is report. You can it is again a very powerful tool in itself. So you can just create a report about how many emails has been sent from the particular journey. So all the things you can report it here. Like it have again some classification like mobile, push, MC admin. So it will contain different sections of reports. So you can define your reports from here. I think journey builder again come with two options like automation studio. So here again, you can create the activities from here, like you are sending the email or create activity. You can just define your activities and emails. So you can have some different activity like send email through this. You can send the email import file. You can define here like particular FTP at particular location. This file should be imported at particular in this format. So these are some standard activity which you can use inside the activity studios tab. Or you can configure your own itself here. You when you have configured the activity, you can define your automation from here. So it will take from the two entry sources, like you want to schedule a particular date or time, the automation should be done. So you can choose from here, or you can choose the file drop, like when a particular file is dropped to a particular directory, then this should be, this automation should be done. So you can see that your FTP should be configured. So here's the folder inside your FTP import. So when the file is dropped inside your import folder, so this automation will run. So you will define all the things like your file name pattern, which type of pattern should be there for the files. So you can define all the things are there. Again, there are so many activities to work with, like file transfer, filter, file events. All the things comes under the automation studio. Like you are just configuring the file, and after that you just wanted to configure a file transfer, like when the file is dropped to the particular designated directory, then a file transfer should be there. And then you can just choose the send email. Then after that, you for the particular data, you want to transfer the file to data extension, or you just wanted to have a query from the data. So you can do all the things from here and define, and just wait for a particular minute. Then you are waiting for 2 minutes, and again you are sending the email. So you just can configure all the things, and the automation run accordingly. So another one is Journey Builder. So Journey Builder is again of two types, like first one is single step and another one is multi-step. So you can define the new journey from here. So it will ask for single send, like if you are selecting for single send, then you are just selecting for data extension from the existing, or create a new one. So like you are selecting this data extension, and you can filter the contact accordingly, like for particular particular domain contact, and all those filters can be applied here. And after that, you are choosing like you want to send the email. So you are just defining the email and just schedule it and just validate and click on save and click on send. After that, the email will be sent to the customers available in the data extension. So this will come inside the single send. And for multi-send, you can just take the multiple options are there, like UAS, different entry sources are also there, like data extension, API event, like when a particular API is called out is sent, then the journey will trigger, audience builder, cloud pages, the data is coming from the cloud pages. So there are different entry sources can be there. So another one is like when on selecting the data source, you are sending the email. So you can just drag and drop the things here, like email is sent and you are waiting for one day event. So this one is the wait by attribute, like wait by duration to a particular duration you want to wait. So here different types of flow controls there and different types of updates there, like at a, when email is sent, then you want to update the lead. So you can choose, plan the journey accordingly. So all the things will cover inside the journey builder. Content builder, we go through the content builder, then there are the some predefined content blocks are there inside the content builder. Like when you click on create, then you have some content builder like blocks like A/B test, button, dynamic content, HTML. So those all things you can create and use inside your email or template. If you want to create the email template, then you is again you have provided several options, like you are getting from existing one, so you can choose. So existing one is provided some comes with some predefined one, like basic one. You can choose this one and just plan your template accordingly. Like this one, you are choosing the image block here, then you can define the image block. You can choose it from here, like this one. So, and again, you can define or you can choose certain height and width from here, this one. Or you can define the text block here. So all the things are just drag and drop. And if you want to really make it goal and want to use your coding practice, then again, you can use this HTML editor and design your template. So like this one, a template can be created. Like this one, you can create a template, like you can define the subject, pre-header and all these things. So banner is there, and the personalization can be done, like for a particular, you have different types of different names available inside the data extension. Then you can to just personalize the data, like based on that, this will insert the name from a data extension, and text block is defined as here, and the button link is provided, and some social links are provided. So you can define the define your template accordingly as per your business needs. So this all comes under the content creation inside the content builder. So next one is comes inside the content builder. Here you can use define the attribute groups and data relationship between the customers. So all the things like data designer is there. You can define if you want to map for a particular, like this one, you can say that testing flow. Like here, you can see that here you can map the particular data extension. This one is a test data extension, and you want to map it with another one. Like product, you can take the customer and product relationship. Like you can take the customer email or ID as a primary key and product ID as a primary key, and then just link or associate the data extension with this. So it will provide a good overview for the making the relationship between the data extension that you can use inside your journey builder. So it will provide all contexts, like it will go through all the contexts like mobile or web, or all these contexts will be there. Like you can differentiate it based on the days available, mobile, connect, email, WhatsApp. So all the things comes inside the all context data extension. Here again, you can view the data extension, like some information has come from Salesforce and some from email, mobile, so. So these all mentioned in here, and synchronized data extension again, which is the data extension which you have mapped from the Salesforce, Sales Cloud, or any other cloud. So you can find all the information in there and data extension. So again, you can create and enter the data here from the data extension tab. you can just create and just fill the information inside the data extension. Imports, you can import the data from the particular data extension or list from here. Contact configuration, here we can define the contact configuration, like what whether how you want to map the contact ID. So all these things are for the contact configuration are provided inside there. So this is all about all the channels which are available. A brief overview of the channels. So is this some common journey, like customer click on the Facebook and is directly customer is fetches the commerce applications and the data is engaged with that and captured with the application, and then customer receives the email like you are interested in the product and so on. So and the customer buys the product, then you are providing again the ad to the customer like related to the product or any other product he is desired to, and just map your journey accordingly. So there is some common journey scenario you can plan. Next one is integration with various cloud, like you can integrate the marketing cloud with other cloud like sales or service. So you can just use marketing cloud connect API, which you can directly use inside your sales or service cloud, and then just connect. Here's the some whole process which you can find inside the document or trailhead. So you can take your data from another cloud to the marketing cloud and plan your journey for the customers. So next one is career options. So here are some four certifications are available inside the marketing cloud. First one is administrator, developer, consultant, and architect. So for administrator, these roles should be there, like at the person holding the administrator can will manage all the org and will have the knowledge of user and business administration. So all these things are covered inside the administrator. If you are planning to for a developer certification, then you should be well aware about the content creation and all the programming languages and data API. You should be well aware about these. And consultant architect, so you should have knowledge about marketing strategy, customer journey mapping. So you should be responsible for all these operations for consultant architect. So four certifications are there: marketing cloud email specialist, marketing cloud. So the person having the marketing cloud email specialist can go for the marketing cloud developer, and the person having marketing cloud administrator can go for the marketing cloud consultant. So four certifications are there. So next one, there are some useful links for learning the marketing cloud, like you can go through from the marketing cloud trailhead, you can go from the Salesforce document article, you can go from the website Salesforce ban. Some here the some good content is listed there, so that will be helpful for learning the marketing cloud. And another, and these two links are for marketing cloud connect, then you can use for this one. So these two links for there. And next one is if you guys have any query related to the session, then you can just drop in the comment box. That's all about for today's session. If you are looking for these sessions in future, then just drop your comments in the chat box.
Chitranshi, we have some questions in the chat box, so you can take those questions.
Yes. Okay. Can you please pronounce for some of them? Do we have a developer or for marketing cloud? No, we don't have a developer or for marketing cloud. It is a paid. If you are associated with any business, then you can take it from there. But right now, there is no developer or because we are sending the email and all the things. Those have some additional costs. So it is not a free version for right now. Okay, can we create custom role in marketing cloud? Yes, we can create the customer role in marketing cloud by defining some certain permissions from there. Can we connect multiple CRM to one marketing cloud? Yes, we can connect for multiple CRM to one marketing cloud. Obviously, we can connect. Those you have to install for separate to store marketing cloud connect in several like sales cloud and different orgs. You have to install for this, for that. Customer, okay. I think most of the questions has been answered. That is good to see. Multi org enable once the email are being rolled out. Can we run a report of how many emails were bounced? Yes, we can. We can report of how many emails are were bounced and how many users are unsubscribed from the report section as well. Or you can do it with your SQL query also. Is there any use of Apex in marketing cloud? No, Apex is not used in the marketing cloud. So we use automation like trigger or workflow or process builder. No, we don't use the workflow or process builder here, but here is some auto for automation purpose. There is automation studio separately from where you can automate your activities. Is it like marketing cloud require less code, more like yes, you can say that marketing cloud required less code. If you are beginner to the coding, then you can definitely go for that. But if you have hands on the programming language, that it is the additional advantage for this. Can we update CRM from marketing cloud if a customer opt out? Yes, we can do this by using the journey builder. So this be pushed back to the CRM. Okay, the status of a subscriber from active to unsubscribe marketing flow and the email opted out field is enabled in Salesforce. Is anyone of following experts? Okay, if a customer responds to social posts, yes, we can. If a customer responds to a social post posted on Facebook, then we can directly respond. Then there is a separate workspace inside the social studio, so we can directly interact with the customer and directly respond to the customer from the social studio window. Okay, if you want this, I will share the PPT with the group leaders and they will forward to you. Okay, I'm sharing the links in chat.
That's it. I think we are done with the questions. So we can start with a quiz session. So thank you, Chitranshi, for conducting this insightful session. And like participants, if you feel any, like if you have any queries, questions, then you can reach out to us or you can reach out to Chitranshi on the LinkedIn platform and get your queries solved. So now it's time for the quiz. I hand over to for conducting the quiz session. Over to you, Sagar.
Sonali, thanks a lot. Chitranshi, thanks a lot for your quick session on this particular, I guess, like in a short time span, we covered most of the things. So now we can start with the quiz. I guess like most of the people are aware of Kahoot, but as do remember, like this is a fastest finger quiz. So the attendees need to select the correct answer in the fastest time. And accordingly, the winner will be displayed on the screen by Kahoot.com competition. And like top three winners will receiving a certification voucher on their email. So let's begin with the quiz. I'll just share my screen quickly. Just let me know. Yes. Invisible.
Not yet, Sagar.
Is it now? It's not visible yet?
No, it's not visible.
Just a moment, I'll reshare it.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yes, Agar, it's visible now.
Okay. Okay, so you just need to mention your name, just need to type www.kahoot.it in your mobile or else in your laptop and type this particular game pin code. And after mentioning this particular code, you will be able to log in into that and then we'll start with the session.
It's also been shared in the chat. Kindly enter the link in your respective browsers. And include the name in the team name as well.
I see people are joining the session. Naman, Ashish, Monica. Omar. So you just need to mention your name on that particular name and like after the team will be coming and there also you need to mention your name single time and you will be able to log in into that. I guess 40 people have joined here. Okay. 41. So we'll start the session in another 2 minutes. Let's see. 44. Okay, 45. Another 1 minute, and then we will start.
One is able to join. It's pretty simple. Like just enter the link, mention the pin name, and proceed by entering your respective names.
Okay. Okay, let's begin with the session. I'm just sharing my screen and like having a first question on the screen. So which option is used for larger deal size? Pardot, Marketing Cloud, Sales Cloud, Service Cloud?
Yeah, I think this one is an easy one. I have already told in the beginning of the session.
Correct. I guess like 39, 40, 40 people have answered this. 44, 46, 48. Okay. So the correct answer is Pardot. Now, going to the result, Vikram is on the top, Harshal is on the second, Surbi is on the third, and Kabir is on the fourth, and like fifth device leading. Coming to the next question. What should be used when fast import speed is there? List, data extension, publication list, suppression list. This is also pretty simple, straightforward.
Yes.
40, 42. I've answered this. 44, 46. 47, three more people. Okay. So correct answer is data extension.
Yes, I think most of the people have correctly.
Correct, yeah. Going to now we'll see the scoreboard. Vikram is on the top, Kabir is on the second, Surbi is on the third, Rashmi is also leading on the fourth, and Divya is on fifth. Coming to the next question. Which statement is true? A subscriber can contact, but a contact cannot be a subscriber. A contact can be a subscriber, but a subscriber may or may not be a contact. A subscriber and contacts are always the same. A subscriber and contact cannot be the same. It's a bit tricky one, I guess. Like still 43 people have answered, 45. So the correct answer is a contact can be a subscriber, but a subscriber may or may not be a contact. Let's see the scoreboard. 15 have answered, 16, 17, 25, 26, 39, okay, 44, okay. So the correct answer is Ajax. Let's see the scoreboard. Surbhi is leading on the first position. Second is Nitesh. Third is Meenakshi. Fourth is Harshal. And fifth one is Kabir. Let's see the next and the last question. Which studio is not a part of Marketing Cloud? Email Studio, Web Studio, Social Studio, Journey Studio. Okay, 34 have answered. 36. 39, 41, 43, okay, 43. So the correct answer is Journey Builder. Let's see the scoreboard and see. So on the third position, Harshal. Second, Nitesh. On the top, it should be. So we have seen the winner on the screen, and the winners are like Surbhi on the first, second we have Nitesh, third we have Harshal. I hope all have added on their knowledge and like enjoy this quiz time. Thank you all for the participation in the quiz and congratulations to all the winners. So maybe like everyone can post their email IDs on the chat so that we'll just send the particular respected vouchers on their email ID.
Yes, and also the email address that you will be sharing, that must be linked to your WebSessor account. So we need that email account, as Salesforce would directly send a voucher to you.
Exactly.
Yes, and first name and last name, or your full name we need in the chat box. Please share.
Thanks a lot everyone for joining this session. At last, we would like also specially thanks to Sudarshan for volunteering this event for such an interesting poster. Thanks a lot everyone, and thanks a lot Chitranshi for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye, take care.
Bye-bye.
Take care.